Welcome to Java Forum. Now we are going to see how to install and configure OpenLiberty 17 application server on Suse Linux Enterprise Desktop 15. So here you can see that I have already downloaded OpenLiberty 17 zip file from OpenLiberty website. So this OpenLiberty application server is IBM's open source project. This OpenLiberty application server is free to use and develop Java enterprise modules. So I'm going to extract this zip file to /opt directory. Make sure that you have enough permission to extract the OpenLiberty 17 zip file to /opt directory. So extraction is completed. So I'm going to create one directory manually. So I'm creating one directory called OpenLiberty 17. So and I am going to move the extracted content to OpenLiberty 17 directory. Yes. So now I am going to open one terminal and I am giving permission to this OpenLiberty 17 directory, so that other users also can execute OpenLiberty 17 commands. Also, I am checking whether Oracle JDK 8 is available in the terminal. Yes, Java 8 is available in the terminal. So this is the data structure of OpenLiberty 17 application server. Contains bin directory, clients directory, dev and lib directory. So lib directory contains lot of jar files used by OpenLiberty application server, and dev directory contains jar files used by servlets and EJBs. Now next step is I am going to OpenLiberty bin directory. So my first command will be /server create Suse Liberty. So the Suse Liberty is the name of the instance name. This will create one instance called Suse Liberty. You can see that Suse Liberty instance is created. Now I am visiting to the OpenLiberty 17 directory. You can see that USR directory is created. Under USR directory, you can see that server. Under servers, you can see that Suse Liberty instance is created, which contains three directories: work area, drop-ins, etc. So these three directory will be available for all server instances. So now I am starting the Suse Liberty instance /server start Suse Liberty. This command will start the instance called Suse Liberty in background. You can see that process ID is generated. So I am grepping that process. You can see that Suse Liberty instance is started, and manually you can verify in the logs. So this is a console.log. You can verify the logs whether that application server is started or not. And messages.log will give you complete details. Yes, you can see that complete details are printed in messages.log. And you can see that the Suse Liberty instance is started in the port 9080. So 9080 is the default port for instance which I have created. So if I have more instance, means that second and third instance will have different port number. So first instance will have default port 9080. You can see that OpenLiberty application server is running in the port 9080. So I can able to see the home page. So now next step is I am going to stop this instance. This is the command /server/stop/suse-liberty. This will stop the instance called suse-liberty. So now let me refresh the page. Yes, you can see that instance is stopped. So these three commands are very, very basic commands: server start, server create, server stop. So these three commands are very basic. Next, /server/list command will list down what are the instances you have created and available under USR directory. You can see there only one instance is available. /server/list will list down the instances available in the USR directory. Next command is /server/run suse-liberty. So this will start the suse-liberty instance in foreground. You can see that logs are printed in the terminal, which means that process is running in foreground. Again, I also able to browse the page. So what is the usage of this foreground processes? You can stop this process simply pressing the Control C button. Yes. So Open Liberty 17 application server installation on Suse Linux Enterprise Desktop 15 is successful.